Microwave Pioneers, Husqvarna Electronic. The story of the Swedish microwave pioneers started in 1957 when Husqvarna Vapenfabrik got hold of a magnetron for dielectric heating from the West German manufacturer Deutsche Mikrowelle in Freiburg. Intrigued by its possible uses, Husqvarna quickly started work with the magnetron to make a new and exciting product for the masses. The leader for the project was Göran Öjelid, an electronic engineer who devoted his whole life to the microwave oven. In 1958, at the Swedish Exhibition Center in Gothenburg, Husqvarna could, as the first Swedish company, show the new wonder of the space age, electronic cooking. Husqvarna themselves called it cold heat, since the oven didn't get particularly warm. The first ovens were heavy, weighing in at over 75 kilograms, most of them being water-cooled. These first ovens were primarily aimed at the restaurant, catering, and canteen market. The profit margins were slim, but the project got much attention in the Swedish press. The Swedish National Railroads and Scandinavian Airline Systems were among the first to install microwave ovens for easy heating of food. The clip that follows is a promotional film made by Husqvarna to market the microwave oven in the United Kingdom.
Since man first discovered the use of fire and gave up eating raw food, a great deal has happened in the art of cooking. 50 years ago, the gas stove, and later the electric range, revolutionized cooking in the kitchen. But a great deal of time still has to be spent in the preparation of our food. Husqvarna Vapenfabrik, a factory with a 300-year-old tradition in the same place, now presents a brainchild of the space age in which we live, the electronic cooker. In the Husqvarna Electronic, cooking is done by quite different methods from those of an ordinary oven, which has first to be heated and the heat then transferred to the food. In the electronic cooker, heating occurs in the food while the cooker remains cold. The method of operation is roughly analogous to television broadcasting. A transmitting station and a receiving station are used in both cases. In a TV set, the electromagnetic energy is converted into a picture, while in the electronic cooker, it's converted into heat. As a result of rapid heating, the food retains its appetizing appearance, vitamin content, and nutritional value better than through heating by any other known method. It must be wonderful for the hard-worked housewife to be able to put on the food the instant her husband comes home, and have it all ready to serve at the very moment he chooses to take his place at the dinner table. But this latest technical advance is naturally of immense importance for catering on a larger scale in restaurants or staff canteens. Here, the pre-cooked food is prepared at a food factory, heated in the electronic cooker, and served by unskilled personnel. In this case, no kitchen is required at all. Cooking in hospitals is carried out centrally, and the food subsequently heated up in the various departments. On ships, aircraft and trains, pre-cooked food is loaded on board before the start of the journey, and can then be heated and served as and when it's required. In schools, motels, all-night cafeterias, and so on. This system greatly facilitates catering and also makes it more profitable. Cooking has always been considered bothersome, but in the future, perhaps we'll not need to spend so much time on it. Like a lot of other work that was once a vital necessity and which modern technology has helped us to eliminate, in the future, cooking will be merely a hobby, though we will never begrudge the time we sit down in peace and quiet over a pleasant meal.
In the early 60s, Husqvarna went on to acquire the German magnetron manufacturer to secure production. By the mid-1960s, Husqvarna exported microwave ovens to Norway, Finland, Denmark, Great Britain, France, the United States, and Canada. Husqvarna regularly had advertisements in the newspapers regarding this invention, which was supposed to change the way we lived. In 1964, a Husqvarna electronic oven would have set you back about 4,500 Swedish krona. Compare this with the average wage in Sweden being roughly 1,500 Swedish krona per month. After seeing the great success in restaurants and in catering, work began on an oven for domestic use. And after much work, Husqvarna could, in 1965, present a smaller version of the original electronic oven, called Husqvarna Electronic Privat. It was presented with lots of attention from media, and Husqvarna had demonstrations and shows with hot food. Electronic Privat didn't become the success Husqvarna had hoped for. At a cost of roughly 3,900 Swedish krona, it was still too expensive for the average family. The whole concept of the microwave oven was reworked, and in 1968, a radically new and unique oven was revealed for the world to see, the new Electronic 2000. As with most things of this era, it had this space-age futuristic design by Karl-Arne Breger. Karl-Arne had previously designed many products both for Husqvarna Vapenfabrik and Husqvarna Borstfabrik. The new microwave oven was shown at the Idéskök exhibition in 1968. In 1970, Husqvarna went on to work with Electrolux to introduce an identical oven to the Electronic 2000, branded as the Electrolux Microlux. The oven that I have is the original Husqvarna branded one. Mine was made in 1971, making it 50 years old. Who would have thought that it would still function after that amount of time? With a whopping 1 kilowatt of microwave power, it quickly heats frozen food. There's no option to turn on the power. I will show more of this oven in a separate video. Still, at a cost of about 2,860 Swedish krona, it was expensive, and not many were made, approximately 5,000 to 6,000 during the first 4 years. Electronic 2000 was later reworked into the more production-line-friendly model named 2001, subsequently renamed to the more well-known name Cupol, meaning dome in Swedish. This brought the cost down to under 2000, bringing it within reach for more people. The dome-shaped oven was abandoned by Husqvarna in 1974-75, and new, more traditional-style microwave ovens were introduced, the Electronic 105 and 106 being two of them. The fate of the Swedish-made Husqvarna microwave ovens came in 1978, when Husqvarna was acquired by Electrolux. Electrolux had the same year purchased Tappan in Ohio. Tappan was one of the American pioneers in microwaves. Tappan had as early as 1955 produced microwave ovens for home use.